So these schemes actually have names, and the names are kind of what you'd expect. One of them is called Encrypt-then-MAC, because you encrypt, and then you MAC, and you send both the encryption and the MAC of the ciphertext. That was the first idea that we saw. The second idea is called MAC-then-Encrypt, because we first compute the MAC, and then we shove both the MAC and the message into the encryption. So one of them is MAC then encrypt, one of them is encrypt then MAC. I always forget which is which, but thinking about the steps that it's telling you can be helpful. So one question you might have now is, which one is better? We've already shown that if you use them correctly, both of them give you INDCPA confidentiality and EUCPA integrity. But there is one very subtle flaw in MAC then encrypt. And the very subtle flaw is that you first have to decrypt before you can detect tampering. So if we look at the way that you would process the message if you're Bob and you receive it, in the encrypt then MAC case, you first check the MAC. So if something is tampered, you check the MAC, it's no good, and you stop right away. By contrast, in the MAC then encrypt scheme, everything you get is encrypted. So the very first thing you have to do is decrypt this message to get the original message and the MAC. And only after decrypting can you then compute if the MAC is correct. So in encrypt then MAC, you check integrity first. In MAC then encrypt, you have to decrypt before you can check integrity. And there are very subtle flaws associated with the fact that you have to decrypt first. In particular, the attacker can give any arbitrary value to Bob, and Bob is forced to decrypt it because he doesn't know if this is correct until he has done the decryption. So if you use MAC then encrypt, you're basically creating a character Bob who will decrypt anything you give to him. So if I give Bob some garbage value, Bob is forced to first decrypt it, and only then can he check the MAC and realize, oh, this is invalid, I'll throw it away. So you've basically created someone in one of our threat models. This is Bob, and you can trick him into decrypting any value of your choice. Now, it's true that in general, Bob is not going to decrypt it and then give the value back to you, but maybe there are some leaks. Maybe somehow Bob is leaking information about the decryption, or the time that it takes him to decrypt leaks some information about the message. So we have to be really careful, because creating this decryption oracle, and that's what you call Bob, who's decrypting anything you provide. You call him a decryption oracle, because you can pass him whatever you want, and he will decrypt it. Providing this decryption oracle is dangerous, because Bob could potentially leak information about the decryption or the key that you're using to decrypt. So we don't like MAC then encrypt, because it creates a character Bob who will decrypt anything you give to him, and only after he decrypts can he detect that something has been tampered with. So in summary, we always prefer encrypt than MAC, because this doesn't open us up to the same problem. Bob immediately checks the MAC, and if it's wrong, he doesn't do any decryption at all. So we don't have a decryption oracle who is potentially leaking data and decrypting anything that the attacker provides to him. So at least for our purposes, we're always going to suggest encrypt than MAC, because it's more robust to mistakes. If you mess up and Bob is leaking information, you would much prefer this first case than the second case. Because in the second case, Bob is becoming a decryption oracle and leaking information about decryption. So that's our argument about why encrypt then MAC is the better approach.